you're following along with AI news, then I'm sure you've heard of the strawberry test. The test is that you ask an AI to count the number of the letter R in strawberry. And even though it's a fairly simple and straightforward question for us humans, it highlights some of the limitations that exist with large language models. One big breakthrough came when OpenAI launched the O1 preview model that baked in this technique of chain of thought. Basically, instead of just giving you the answer to a question, the AI will first talk at great lengths about the problem and break it down before trying to solve it and give you the final answer. And the reason this works is baked deeply into how large language models function. LLMs essentially predict the next word and add a little bit of randomness into selecting the next word, which is especially important because it improves the perceived creativity of a text. But it's not a great feature for questions where there's really only one answer and you want consistency in the responses. This is why models typically start with a short message telling you what they're going to do before they provide you with the answer. The cool thing is that chain of thought isn't limited to the O1 preview model. In fact, you can apply the same type of reasoning chain to all the existing models. And by priming the model to give us the correct answer by thinking first, it increases the likelihood of us getting the correct answer. So today, I thought we would have a little bit of fun and see if we can write a chain of thought prompt that can solve the strawberry problem using as small of a model as possible. We'll start with the 8 billion parameter LLaMA 3.1 model, and then if that goes well, we'll try the same prompt on the absolutely tiny 3 billion and 1 billion LLaMA 3.2 models that were just released. So let's get started. All right, then I'm here starting out with Claude first. Let's just see how the top of the line models before 0.1 preview tackle this problem. So let's just try to ask these 3.5 Sonnet, how many R's are in the word strawberry? And let's see if it gives the correct response. All right, so there we saw it. It said there are 2 R letters in the word strawberry, but as we know, there's 3. So, and this is, you know, the top of the line model. But using chain of thought, we can fix this for these like really smart models pretty easily. So what we can do is just tweak this prompt a little bit and say how many R's are in the word strawberry. Use a chain of thought prompt and break the problem down step by step before answering. And by doing this, the likelihood that it's going to be correct increases by a lot. So let's see if that helps. All right, so it broke it down step by step. It counted in quotes the letters, and it came to the correct answer that there's 3. So as we saw, like, all we really did is added this, like, we asked it to use a chain of thought, and that was enough to kind of steer it in the right direction instead of just answering something without reasoning about it first. And this is really all 0.1 preview is doing. I mean, they did a lot more. They trained the model specifically for these sort of like long reasoning tasks before answering. But fundamentally, every model can do stuff like this. So what I of course wanted to try today is can we make very, very small models answer this strawberry problem? And to do that, we first need to write like a really nice prompt. So like, I'm not gonna ask the model to reason itself. I don't think it's good enough to do that, but we're gonna kind of give it an example in a chain of thought way. And then we're gonna feed that together with the word which letters we wanted to calculate. So let's just start. And I'm gonna ask Claude to write the chain of thought prompt for me. So let me try to ask Claude in a nice way to write a prompt for me. All right, we got something here. I'm just gonna ask it to rewrite more as an instruction. So now we got a little bit of a, now we have a chain of thought prompt, and I think this is probably good enough to sort of get started. I mean, at least I think this is going to work for some of the models. Let's see how well it works. So here I have the LLaMA web UI set up, and I have all my local models here. So first, let's start with the 8 billion LLaMA 3.1 model and kind of see how if our prompt works for this. So I'm gonna paste it in, and then I will ask now, can you count the number of the letter R in the word strawberry. Well, of course, like before we do this, we should of course try to ask it just without any prompt. So let's just ask it like how many are in the word strawberry. But since this Sonnet 3.5 could not answer this, I think if it can answer this, it's going to be pretty much dumb luck at this point. But we'll see what it... Okay, so it says there is one R. That's a new one. So it doesn't even think it's two. It thinks there's one R. All right. Now let's try our chain of thought prompt instead. All right. And there we saw. I mean, it took a while. It did it really like slowly, and it was doing it step by step. But it arrived at the correct count. And I think that if we asked it again or used a different word, keep in mind, I didn't use strawberry, of course, as the example word. We used pineapple because we don't want, you know, we don't want to give it the answer and then just ask for the answer back. But this should generalize to most words, right? We it's a LLM, so we don't know for sure it's gonna always be right, but it's gotten a lot better than just saying like, oh, it's one letter, right? So good success with the LLaMA 3.18 billion. Let's try a smaller model. Now we're really getting into the weeds here. Let's try the newly released LLaMA 3.2 3 billion instruct. This is a tiny model. This is a model that you can easily, for example, run on your cell phone because it only needs a couple of gigabytes of RAM, which most cell phones have today. Let's try exactly the same and see how it does. All right, and there we saw a little bit of a breakdown. Let's see how it said it is two instances. So let's see here what it did wrong. So it came to the R here, and that was correct. So counter is one, and then it got to the R here, and it counted to two, and then it missed actually the second R. So I think maybe we need to refine the prompt even further. We need to make it think even more. So let me go back to the to Claude here and try to improve the prompt a little bit. So what I'm thinking is I want to add a step where it basically gives you the whole word at every step. And that way I think it's more likely that it's gonna be able to like not forget any letters. Or maybe we should ask it to calculate how many letters there are so that it also kind of keeps track of that when it's reasoning. All right, so I added this letter counting to the prompt and I added a step where I asked it to kind of try to count the number of letters first. This step feels a little iffy to me. I don't know if it's good enough, but we can certainly give this a try. Let's go back to the LLaMA 3.2 instruct here. Let's go and start a new chat, get the prompt in there, and finally we should add our strawberry word. Right, yeah, that did not work out very well either. And I think the problem is that it just doesn't know how to count the number of letters. I'm kind of wondering if we should maybe skip this step, but then do the thing where we ask it to space out the letters. All right, so I've been playing around with this prompt and this is what I ended up with. So I added a few steps. So the first thing I do is to ask it to identify the letter to count. Then I actually ask it to convert every letter to an emoji. And the reason for doing that is because large language models, they don't read like letter by letter, they read token by token. And usually there's multiple letters in the same token, and that's why it gets so confused on this double P, because it sees it as one token and it just doesn't know what to do with that. So one technique you can use is to ask it to make an alternative representation, like I did in this case, where I asked it to convert each character into an emoji and then write out the word as the emoji representations, which hopefully one emoji is one token. And then basically count that way. So after it converted everything to emojis, I'm asking it to check if the current letter is equal to the target letter, and then if it is, to increment the counter. So you're kind of doing it like step by step. This is the chain of thought, that it kind of goes through the steps step by step and hopefully arrives at the correct solution. It counts all of this and it does it correctly, and then at the end it will actually give you the correct answer. So let's see how it did that. So it converted each letter into an emoji, and then it did the calculations and it arrived at the correct result. And it doesn't always arrive at the correct result. I don't know exactly how often it arrives mostly at the correct result, maybe at least half the time or more than half the time. So we're definitely not talking about, you know, with the chain of thought, you can make a really small model be like just as good as ChatGPT. But you can, as you can see, you can significantly increase the likelihood of getting the correct result by using this chain of thought approach. Now, I did try this approach with the smaller models. So like I tried it with the 3B model, but generally it just does not work that well. The model is just too small. Like, and it does these extremely basic mistakes. Like here it assigned, this is the 3B model, here it assigned the same emoji to two different letters. So the 3B model, for example, can do these really silly mistakes. Like it will say something like, the current letter is R, is R equals to R? No, right? And at that point, there's just like not much we can do when the model is kind of that silly. But I still think that it is pretty cool that we can improve the performance for a model just by kind of asking it to do things step by step. And in order to get to this chain of thought prompt, I've been using Claude to basically help me write and iterate, and asking it to refine and trying out different things. So I hope you like the video. I hope you try chain of thought prompting if you're doing local models or smaller models and doing stuff with that. And I would love to hear how chain of thought works for you, and whether you have some tips, like maybe there is a way to make the chain of thought approach work for the strawberry example on these smaller models. I would love to hear your ideas for how we could do that. So thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.